Hello everybody, here's Karuna, and this video will be about notes on the Armenian Dudu. If we tune in into the key of A, which will be here, you see, now I am a little bit higher, so I have to adjust the ring to release it a little bit. It's a little bit higher still, so I'm a little bit raising it. Like this is good. I'm tuning in by playing A and then playing E like this. This interval. If they are fitting, that means we are in tune. So, if you close all the holes on the duduk in A, you will get the note of F sharp, but this is not the lowest note on your duduk. This you must know, because there is one hole here which is the lowest hole and which is on the back side of your duduk. So, and this is the note of E. This one you can play with your belly, and I will show it later to you how we do it. So you start with F sharp, the position 4 and 4, and one thumb here. So this is F sharp. Next one, next open hole will be G sharp. Next one will be A. I change my position to play in more comfortable position. Next one will be B. Next one, C sharp. While playing C sharp, you have to press your lips just a little bit. So it is that the construction of the duduk itself is such that you have to do it on the correctly tuned duduk. You have to not only to play it with relaxed lip, not only to close the fourth hole, but also to press your lips a little bit, because the note itself is a little bit lower, as it should be. You see, I just pressed just a little bit, and this you can, you have to have a hearing for it. So the next note, opening this index finger, will be the note of D. But the note of D on the correctly tuned duduk is a bit higher than it should be. On the piano, I don't know why. What are the reasons to make tuning like this? But it is like this. So, how do we do to make the sound lower? So we make a little shadow here. So not really closing the hole, but just hanging above like that. Like that, you see. Not half note, but just hanging above. So, and when I after I opened all these fingers, so I need some points where I keep touching the duduk, so that it is stable in my hands, you know. You see, I start touching it here, and actually in the position 3 and 3 I never take away this index finger. So this index finger keeps touching the duduk, and here I also start touching the duduk after I open this finger. So the next one will be the note of E, this. This note, F sharp. Then it goes, I open the thumb like that, and I press my lips again, not too much, not too little, but a little bit more than it was on the note of C sharp. So like that. So what I'm doing is a little bit this, from all the sides, from upper lip and from lower lip. Like this. So you cannot see it because I really press press my lips together just a little bit, you know, like from up from here and from here. It just goes like this, and then the next note, the note of, so it was like F sharp, that was G sharp when we pressed our lips. It was G sharp again, and then when you open everything but you keep your finger staying on the duduk and sometimes making a little bit shadow, it depends on the maker of the duduk. So you will get again the note of A of a higher octave. So here we had the note of A, the keynote, and then again when we open up everything we have again the note of A. So after that you can only make some higher notes by pressing your lips. So you cannot do any more with your fingers, but with pressing your lips together you can go to A sharp or B flat, which is the same, and then to B, like that. You see? So in this lesson I'm not showing you how to play the half tones, so just for you to know that between F sharp and G sharp we have also the note of G, and this is this note is also possible to be played. So this is by opening the little finger just a little bit, you know. For this you need to know a little bit the musical theory, but just very very little, not too much. In one of the lessons I will show you how to play the half tones and which half tones are on the duduk, but in this lesson it's enough that you just remember F sharp, G sharp, A, B, C sharp, D, E, F sharp, G sharp, A sharp, B with the lips, you know, and which is also important here for you to remember when you have to have your lips relaxed and to play the note properly, and when in which case you have to press them a little bit to get the right note. So again, here we had our lips relaxed, you know, relaxed, a little bit pressed, here a little bit shadow, and fingers touching the duduk here, so that it's stable. Then here relaxed, here a little bit pressed. You see, I'm doing like after playing the note of E, I come to F sharp, and my ring finger comes down again like that. So it's not necessary to do, but it's much more comfortable to hold your duduks in your hands if you make this fork. It just gives more stability to it. So I'm always playing F sharp by having my ring finger on the third hole as well, like that. Then you open this one, you press your lips in this moment to get the note a bit higher, and then you relax your lips again, you get again the note of A, and then a little bit up if you need. So again, here we had the note of F sharp of a lower octave, and as you remember, here again the F sharp of a higher octave. So we have two F sharps on our A duduk. Yeah? So here we had G sharp, and G sharp was, you remember, when we had only one finger on the duduk and we pressed our lips, so it was again G sharp. And then the key was A, and if you open up everything you get A. So the next one here was B, and then, you know, when you press your lips you get to higher B, like that. So even like on very very good and also tough reeds you can get to the next note after B, you know, you can get to C, but normally nobody does it, so it's kind of not reliable, I guess. And it is possible to do if you have I don't know if it's the right word in English, if you have a valve here, so a little metal thing which normally the clarinets have and the flutes, silver flutes, you know, you open the holes with these valves, with these metal things. The same device you can also install in the Dudok, not on every key, so it must be enough distance here to be installed, and then you can get the higher B very very easy. And then if you press it the same way you pressed if you didn't have it to get the B, you can get to the C, you know, like that. So some makers also can make this metal thing here for you if you ask to do this. Maybe $50 more and you can get this thing also. And the lowest hole here on the backside of the Dudok, you just close with your belly, or if you are sitting on the floor with your legs crossed, you can also close the hole with your knee. For this, first of all, you have to close everything, and then even you can close a half of it. You know, just making some shadow with your belly. The ones who have a bigger bellies, it's easier to close this hole actually. But in my case, I always have to fill it up with air, you know, and then only I close it. So it takes a lot of time basically, and a lot of training to get this hole closed as quick as you want. Because when you are playing before people, you really this is a big distance to make, you know, like you must be prepared to do it. And with your knee, you just choose the softest part of it, not the bones, not this area, like you know, but this one. Like this, and then you get the note of E. In this lesson, the practice for you will be to play the scale of A major or C major on the accepted Dudok note. So in this one I have already shown you. Let's go again through it one more time. Just for you to know that every note on the Dudok, as I shown you, is in the scale of A major when you are playing the drone in A, like this. Even this low note. So we are tuning into the drone in A. The lips must be relaxed. Like this. So the A major was. To go to the low notes, you have to switch the position like this. Why can we go to these two lower notes? Because when we played here, this note, it was G sharp, and G sharp we also have here, you know, here. So that means we can also play the G sharp. Doesn't matter that it is in the lower octave, we can do it. So, and why we play this one when all holes are closed? Because it's F sharp, and F sharp we played here. So that means we can also do this. Even we can do this with the belly, the note of E, because the note of E was here. So like this you can think in a musical way. So this will be a practice for you, just to remember the notes and to play the scale of A major up and down, as I showed you. So it's good for today. We are good. Enjoy your Dudok practice and see you in my next videos. Ciao, ciao.